During the next 5 minutes, I am going to show you how to save $20 by not buying this book. Of course, you could save the $20 and 5 minutes by not watching this video, but in this video, you will learn the three essential things you need to know to design and build a hydrofoil boat. The premise is anyone who can build a model airplane can build an actual flying hydrofoil boat. Basically, a hydrofoil is a small underwater airplane whose wings lift the hull above the surface. The wings fly through the water. You don't need to buy my book to build a hydrofoil. My friend Harry Larson didn't buy this book, and he designed and built Tellaria 4. Kataro Horiuchi didn't buy before creating the OU-32. Dwight Philly, the father of Mach 0.03, didn't buy. And John Islett didn't. And look at this marvelous moth sailing hydrofoil that he created. Of course, they all contributed to the text, so they got a free copy. Then they read it. Harry, Kataro, Dwight, and John first learned about hydrofoils the way I did, by years of studying and experimenting. And you too can do that. But right now, I will give you a jump start by explaining the three essential things you need to know to create a hydrofoil boat. The three things are: determine foil size, control height, and control roll. Foil size is determined by this simple equation found on page 30. Surface area equals lift divided by the product of velocity squared times the coefficient of lift. Hi-Fi's rear foil at takeoff, rounded off to simplified numbers, is 288 pounds divided by 12 feet per second times 12 feet per second times 1. That equals 2 square feet, or 288 square inches. Next, we look at height control. A hydrofoil must fly in a very narrow range of heights. Precise control is essential. Hi-Fi uses a surface sensing ski that is attached to a movable strut and a front foil. When hull borne, the front foil has an angle of attack of 7 degrees. At cruise height, its angle is reduced to 0 degrees. Lift decreases with flying height, so the bow will rise to its design height and remain there. The rear foil will find its own height depending upon the boat's velocity, the foil's angle of attack, and its area as determined by the previous calculation. Finally, we look at roll control. Without it, the boat will simply flop over. Hi-Fi uses a joystick linked to wingtip flippers. The flippers serve the same purpose as the airplane's ailerons. So now you know the three essential principles. In the 250 pages of my book, Hydrofoil, Design, Build, Fly, there's a chapter written on each of these principles. There are 9 other chapters covering important hydrofoil topics such as history, power, drag, and stress calculations. There are chapters dedicated to specific designs of sail, human, and motor-powered hydrofoils. Sails are brisk. Oh. Thanks, Mom.
When are you going to get a real job?
Oh, Mom. Mom paid $30, but your savings will be just $20, because that is a discounted price that you will not be paying at Amazon.com if you do not buy the book. Of course, if you buy the book, it'll cost you $20. The principles of hydrofoils can also be learned by studying a wealth of free government and university documents, as well as aerodynamic books available free at your local library. Of course, the best way to learn is by doing. In fact, you can save hours of studying by doing just a few months of building and testing. Designing and building hydrofoils is a rewarding thing, and flying one is more fun than almost anything. In conclusion, whether you are a competitive moth pilot or simply a fan of hydrofoils, this book tells you what you need to know. On the other hand, if you're a rugged pioneering type who enjoys reinventing things like boiling water or the wheel, don't buy this book.